Come on.
OBS.
Hurry.
It's okay. I'm coming. Lion face, lemon face.
Lion face, lemon face. I have no idea what's going on.
Okay. Are you ready? Two, three, start. Moving. Okay. This is good.
Yeah. It's good.
Oh, you're getting way ahead of me. What even is this?
I'm not
This is
pushing.
Some kind of female privilege going on here.
Wait, look. The moms are falling.
Right. I'm just going to start talking and shit. Oh, well, hello, chaps. It's Commodore Graham here, and welcome to episode 4 on the Eureka server, featuring the indomitable and inevitable Countess Lovelace.
Hello, folks.
Yep. We've been threatening it for a while, but now we're actually going to subject you to the Countess's greatness. Plus, she builds most of the shit around here, so it's about time. Now, you may be wondering, why are we going round and round this big cobble structure on a rail? Well, I guess we'll go through that really briefly. This is the mob spawner that I've been putting together that was in the last episode. I've got it all covered up, all the water streams are going, but it just really wasn't working very well at all. And as you can see, it's now working kind of okay, I suppose. It's not finished yet. It's going to have about... Oh, I'm catching up. I think you had a bit too big of a breakfast, honey. I'm catching up with you now. So yeah. Anyway,
oh,
yes.
There goes some more mobs.
Uh-huh.
They are falling.
Oh, it's yeah.
So are you going to explain why we have
Oh,
a rail?
Right. Yeah. So... apparently things don't work the way that they used to. You have to be, 24 blocks away from somewhere before mobs can spawn there. So that's all well and good. But apparently mobs stop moving if you're 32 blocks away from them. That's how the game works now. So I was out on a platform out there hanging over the swamp, thinking, haha, all the things will spawn, all the things will fall. You're getting ahead again. This is weird.
I didn't do anything.
Have you got like a desktop fan on the back of your minecart? Is that what's happening?
No comment.
Okay. So someone's messing with the laws of physics, and I suspect you. But yeah, so I was sort of standing on my platform, and maybe only like 10% of the mob farm will have been spawning mobs. Well, it'll all have been spawning mobs, but only about 10% of them were able to wander into the water streams.
You're really far away.
Look. Yeah, this is going to work increasingly badly as we get further away from each other. So, in order to allow mobs to spawn everywhere and to be close enough to every spawning platform inside this sucker, you have to go round and round it. So the obvious way of doing that would allow you to go AFK is a rail. And we did some calculations, and then the Countess did some better calculations and figured out that if we have a rail 8 blocks away, all the way around, we'd get them spawning everywhere, and then at some point on our journey around the spawner, mobs would throughout the spawner be able to wander and hence fall into the water streams, which take them to the center hole where they fall and die.
Otherwise they just stand still. They don't move.
Yes.
So
it's entirely vexing. I didn't know what the hell was going on for a while, and I thought, I've built this spawner and it's basically useless. I might as well just be going around hunting mobs at night or something. But anyway, do you think we've done enough explanation of that?
Sorry, I'm having kitty problems.
Oh, yeah. You see, the Countess just recently fed her. Oh God, I'm getting some lag here. Recently fed her kitty some of the old catnip. And is he getting a little frisky? Is that what we have going on here?
That's one way of putting it. I mean, I guess he is a cat.
Is he like climbing all over you and shit?
Yes.
Oh well.
Well, he's fine. I put him down. I'm not down. I mean, I put him on the floor.
You wait, haven't euthanized your cat for the purposes of a YouTube video, is what you're saying?
No, I did not.
No,
did
not. No. Yeah.
They're still falling. You can hear them.
Yeah, I saw one of them. So here's the idea here. We have hoppers underneath this carpet, which is purple provisionally. It's provisionally purple. And this is some sort of sacrificial altar, right? That's the notion that I had. So you have this thing up here that's going to be a pyramid, with mobs falling onto a sacrificial altar, and it's going to be sacrificed to some deity, some arcane god of distant times past. But more on that later. We don't want to spoil everything, do we? She agrees. Right.
I did just nod.
Oh, that's true. That's true, actually.
So what do we have? That's not too bad.
Yeah, you know, it's not the most super, super effective spawner ever.
But it's lag friendly for the server.
Yeah. Yeah, well, it's maybe not lag friendly for my client, because I drop to about like 30 frames a second when I'm up there and looking at it. But that's okay. That's fine. I am running this shader pack after all. So, yeah, we got... hold on, I'll go under here. We have a line of connected up hoppers. They all go to this chest. It's all pretty simple stuff. But... that is not really the main subject of this video, featuring Countess Lovelace.
Oh, jeez.
That's right.
Yeah.
So,
where do you want to start?
I don't know. Well, I guess we're close to the barn, and farm. Okay, so show us what you got, Countess.
Well, that's the barn. I don't know if you want to start with the barn or just the sheep.
That's a sheep farm. Should we build up to the barn?
Yeah, we'll build up to the barn. Get some piggies.
Mm-hmm. So tell me about your thought process and workflow with this area.
God. Thought process. How about I did a thing. I said, "Do you like the thing?" And you said, "It's ugly." And then I had to redo the thing.
That is not at all an accurate representation of what happened, folks. I vehemently deny everything.
You're like, "I don't like this, and I don't like that, and I don't like this other thing, and why do you have that?"
Yeah,
I said, "Tough luck."
This is how I spur the Countess on to ever and ever higher levels of Minecraft greatness. I say, "This sucks. And you suck, and stop sucking so hard. Try harder." not to suck, but to Minecraft.
Yeah. So we just picked some of the, I guess, like, harder to get colors.
Yeah, because some dyes are more expensive than others, and harder to get than others.
Yeah, the ones that use lapis.
So yeah. We have the blue sheep, the, what are these, turquoise sheep?
Cyan?
Same difference. 6 and 2 3s. Six of one and half a dozen of the other.
In here. So if you need to dye the white ones, whatever color, you can just dye them.
That's how it is. And if we need to go on any pig races, we have carrots on sticks. Well, we have one. I'm sure we can rustle up more than one. So we have so we have these sheep, and we have these shaved mutant sheep over here. but when it comes to the actual sheep pens, what the Countess says about the thought process is is partially true, but it does not quite cover the full creative wonderment of the situation. So, looking at my frame rate, I got like 20 frames per second here. Jesus. Oh,
really?
Well.
I have 60.
Oh, hey, it's raining. Fantastic.
Oh, you should show how the rain actually looks better with this shader pack.
Oh, yeah. Let's go for a wander, shall we?
The floor looks wet.
Yeah. Do puddles start forming right away?
Yes.
Or what? Okay. So I'm trying to find some... I can't hear the rain sounds at all. Do I have...
I turned mine down.
Oh, I've got my weather down at 2%, I guess. And my game sounds are down even further. So what happens in this shader pack? Maybe it takes some amount of time, because I'm not seeing... Oh, yeah. I think the ground is starting to get kind of shiny now. If I go at an angle to things... Here. I think you can see this. Oh, you can see the reflection of the torches here too.
Yeah.
Uh-huh. That's how it be. Some people don't think it be like that, but it do.
Which is really neat.
Yeah. So some areas get kind of shinier and darker than others, which is, I guess, to indicate puddles from the rain. I think it's actually more apparent at nighttime, actually, because everything gets darker, so the reflections get brighter by comparison. But yeah, and if you go underneath trees, it's dry. How magical.
Like in real life.
So this is hyper-realistic Minecraft, where you can't basically tell this from real life at this point.
I know. Can't. Oh, not yet.
Not the barn yet. No. Yeah. So the Count has set up a little wheat farm here so that we can feed our cows. Milk producing sardines, as I like to call them, given how tightly packed in they are. I say as I like to call them, I just made that up right now, but that's what we're calling them now, honey.
Sardines.
Milk sardines.
Milk sardines.
That's right. So I haven't finished looking at your sheep farm yet. So there's some cool little details going on here. There's flat roofs over most of it, but then you've got this kind of arch or whatever it is, or like peaked roof with the beam supporting it. Torches on like little fence post holders here. And I actually really think that the, what they're called, the trapdoors in the back there look absolutely super. And
the roofs are actually slanted and they have slabs and stairs, so they're spawned, nothing will spawn.
Oh, right, it's all stairs or upside down, not upside down slabs, upside down slabs, that's what I call them. Slabs on the bottom half of a block, yes. The building itself is made out of cyan stained clay, much beloved of Ethor, or at least it used to be. He used to love that shit. It looks kind of different, though. Maybe it's because of the shader packs we have going
on. Yeah, I think it's the shader pack. It looks more gray than it does otherwise.
And soon it's going to be more different, isn't it? Because they're changing all the colors.
Are they changing the colors to the clay?
I'm not certain, but I think they might. Be, unless I'm on crack, which is entirely possible, aka likely.
I don't know.
Oh, anyway, look at how shiny the ground is. Ugh, such realism.
I wish.
Many realisms, such shader pack, wow. Sorry, carry on.
I wish that when I jumped, it would like splash like a real puddle.
That would be great. I concur.
That would be.
Okay, let's move on to the next aspect of the farm de Countess.
Yeah, and none of this is like automated. Just, it's all sort of old school.
Yeah. I mean, how many things do you really need? How many eggs do you need? Seriously, really. That's our line of thinking here. So of course, then someone's going to come up with a reason why we actually need a billion eggs, and we'll go, oh. So, tell me about this great work which you have wrought upon the world.
It's a chicken coop.
Oh wow, you're like chick machine gun there. Yeah. So yeah. Tell me about your building of this thing and what you were thinking. What were you thinking? Seriously.
Well, actually, I just went online and looked at actual chicken coops.
Oh.
And usually they're smaller. Like, you know, if you have like a little backyard chicken coop, it's like a little building and then a little outside. Usually, not fence, but it has like screen, so they don't get out.
Mm-hmm.
So we must
keep them trapped
and
enslaved.
Yes, exactly.
No one will notice. Look, they're happy. They don't mind. They're just chilling by his corpse, her corpse.
I hope you're happy.
Are you going to bury it now? Is that what you're going to do? You could. I'll tell you how you could.
All you need to
dig a hole in. Let me. You could dig a hole in the ground. Oh. Put an item frame in there. Put the chicken on the item frame and then cover it up. Voila, buried chicken.
No. Oh, I don't have an item frame.
Oh. Well, you know. Hopefully this chicken won't decay too badly in the intervening time. We need to embalm it or some shit.
Mm-hmm. But yeah, it's actually based on just a picture of an actual chicken coop, the colors.
I think the colors
are funny because it's like egg yolk and white.
Oh, so these colors, these eggy colors, they were on the chicken coop that you based this upon?
Yes, although it's very loosely based.
Oh, okay.
But I saw this little cute little chicken coop with, it was yellow with a little bit of white trim, and I'm like, oh, that looks very cute.
So
I just emulated that. But obviously this is much larger than the one they had, since theirs was just like a little backyard.
So we got some quartz going on here. That's why it looks very expensive.
Which I bought.
Yeah. We've mined literally zero quartz of our own. Is that not correct?
We might have gotten a couple pieces.
Oh, when we were digging up to our nether portal-y place.
Yeah, when we were doing the nether portal. But otherwise, I just bought these from Swan.
Yeah, it's really funny. In terms of resources, we've mostly just been kind of rubbish. We haven't... There's loads of... We haven't even got decent armor or decent enchantments on our things, mostly. It's But yeah, that's not really particularly why we play the Minecrafts. So that's okay. Now, let's move on, shall we, to this wonderful and very American... America, fuck yeah! This very American barn, as designed and built exclusively by the Countess.
Yeah, and for this I did the same thing. I literally just went online and looked at actual barns. Pictures of actual barns. And originally this started with like, you see a lot of like the barn doors have the white X on the front. But it just was way too enormous to do an X.
So it didn't really
work.
And
it didn't quite fit with the rest of our like buildings generally, because you know everything is relatively sized, not enormous.
Yes.
it's all like people sized, I guess.
Before any of you start saying, what is this, a barn door for ants? Just cool it, okay?
Yes.
It looks good.
I mean,
it looks good.
Jeez.
Yeah. And you're bigger than an ant.
And I'm bigger than an ant.
Mm-mm. This is something that must be stressed about the Countess. She's bigger than an ant. Although maybe not.
Yeah.
Maybe not. Oh, no. Even the ones from that crappy fourth Indiana Jones film weren't that big, were they?
I don't even remember them.
No, I don't.
That's how much I enjoyed that movie. I don't even know if I finished watching the whole thing.
How the mighty have fallen. Anyway, we're going off on a little bit of a tangent here. So, tell me about the barn and its various and manifold bits.
Well, I mean, traditional colors, red and white. I mean, at least traditionally American barns.
Yep.
Red and white. And then I added a bit of darker trim because otherwise it was just too red and white. And I did the roof out of dark oak, but I put the white trim on it.
Yeah, which really helps it stand out.
So that way we got slabs on top.
Oh, that's smart. Also, I think that the white trim really helped the roofs stand out. Really gives it structure. Yes. I approve. Should we look inside?
So that's the outside. With, you know, our American flags.
America.
Then you get inside. And this actually, you know, the inside was a little more difficult because we actually wanted it to be a functional barn so that, you know, things wouldn't escape. I'm not entirely happy with the fence posts, but
It's kind of hard to get it. Well, actually, this is the first time I've seen your finished design, I think. And honestly, I think that this is about the best that could be done. It actually looks pretty nice.
It's better than what
we... Because we have to make it so that horses and et cetera can't get out of the pen.
I mean, technically, I think we can get out if we... Yeah, see, if you run and...
Okay, let me try this.
If you're just walking.
Because I'm so good at parkour. I did it, honey! I'm on top of the world!
Not really.
No.
You're just on top of the barn.
Well, I mean, like, I kind of am on top of the world. Like, if you're on the ground, you're on top of the... Never mind! Carry on.
So then you have, you know, the traditional upper level the huge... Normally, I think you have, like, doors here that cover this. So I just put shutter... looking things instead.
Okay. Oh,
like
okay.
You would normally have one huge door that covered the hay barn
I feel like I want to kind of like if my character could lay down, I'd do that and then like I'm just thinking of what is it? Oh Brother, Where Art Thou? Where they wake up in the barn and George Clooney's character is like, "Damn, we're in a tight spot." Like, and he says it three times or something.
In the
same way. It's humorous. Anyway, carrying on.
No, this is just general storage. I don't even think there's very much up here, if anything. It's more just for aesthetics than anything else.
It is very aesthetic.
Very aesthetic.
We got a little balcony right here. It's kind of cool how the edge of the balcony gets wet with the rain, at least with the shader packs.
Yeah.
It's nice.
I mean, it's basically half functional, half aesthetics. Like, you know, I mean, this isn't...
Half functional, half punctual.
What was the second word?
Punctual. I made it up.
Jesus fucking Christ.
I know. Oh, we got a buddy here. We got a couple of buddies.
We have a llama.
Does the llama have a name yet?
No, we haven't named it yet. Also, I don't know, and maybe someone can help. Like, do I have to start breeding him in order to be able to add a chest? Because I couldn't figure out how to add a chest.
Yeah, I know nothing. Oh, whoops. So this llama is tamed, right?
It's tamed, which means you can put a lead on it and and walk it out. Do we have any leads? Yeah, we do.
Yeah. If I shift and...
See?
Okay, so... You have the carpet on this guy, and that's how llamas work, then. You put different coloured carpet on, and you get... They all have different patterns and things, too, I think. I've seen them in other people's videos. Z-Store, to be precise. He has a llama that's trying to communicate with him about, like, an apocalyptic threat to his world. it'll go... But there'll be text underneath, like, you know, warning him of the end times to come. It's really funny.
I don't speak llama.
No, I don't either. So if this llama was trying to
warn
us of impending doom, then I'm sorry, buddy, but your efforts are in vain. Mm-hmm. Hey, doesn't the llama's nose look like a little face?
Yes, now that you mention it. Oh, God, now I can't unsee that.
Oh, God. I've ruined Minecraft for everyone. This Minecraft is ruined. We also have a skeleton horse.
Yeah, although apparently you can't put a lead on it.
Yeah.
But I can, I mean, I put a saddle on it and had to ride it in and that's about it. I couldn't put a lead on it, though.
Very curious.
Yeah, I don't know. Some sort of bug, I think.
Hmm. Oh, well.
But yeah, we don't actually have any, you know, normal horses. Not uh-huh. that, you know, I want to offend our skeleton friend here. I mean,
No. He's quite normal as far as skeleton horses go.
Yes.
He's not a deviant skeleton horse. He's a normal skeleton horse.
He's not a degenerate skeleton horse.
I do not know that this skeleton horse engaging in any degeneracy. Right.
So we need to figure out our horse situation and get some actual horses that we could lead and ride and test and whatnot. But that's for another time.
Indeed.
Okay. So that's the barn. And then, you know, there's a little outside area for hay. And I need to figure out lighting and stuff because I don't really want to have torches everywhere.
My apologies to everyone for my frame rate, by the way. It's way worse than normal and I have no idea why.
That is weird.
Yeah. You know,
what's your field of view? Is it your field of view?
It's just 75. Hang on. Video settings. I think everything's set up how I normally have it. Oh, well, I guess it doesn't matter so much.
That is a bit strange. I mean, yes. I'm getting 60 frames per second, but I won't rub it in.
Maybe it's because I'm actually recording in higher quality than normal.
Oh, maybe.
I don't know. That I don't know.
Be. So I think people have seen our portal.
I'm going to just very briefly have a little bit of a closer look here.
No, that makes sense.
Because there's some quite cool stuff going on. So this is a four-sided portal. And it has kind of these legs or claws or whatever that are sort of gripping onto the mountaintop. That's the notion. Yeah. Or like it's some huge scary black spider or something. It does have eight legs, as it happens. It's an octo portal.
Oh, I guess it does.
Yeah, it's an arachno portal. Is that what we're calling it now?
Well, you seem to be in the habit of giving things names, so sure, why not?
Yeah.
Like what did you call our cows?
That makes me think of that running joke from Stargate Atlantis where Shepard keeps telling Rodney that, or other people, that they can name it later.
They can name it later. Yeah. That's great. But what was the name we gave our cows? Something milk?
Milk sardines.
Milk sardines. That's right.
Yep. Sardines. Which just sounds so wrong. Because you might want milk sardines, but you wouldn't want sardine milk.
You know, it actually looks pretty cool from the middle.
Uh-huh. Let's see.
Yeah, if you look up.
Ooh.
Because we have the
that's relatively
rings and the
yeah and the particles and the random, from
like,
the
particles yeah
that actually looks kind of fancy though. Huh. So yeah, we have some glass here to turn it poiple.
I thought there was glass in the bottom as well inside.
Oh right. But I put it here too, I suppose.
Has people seen our map to Memorial Library?
I think so.
The only thing I did was the thing with the bookshelves and the, I mean.
Okay, we'll look at that in just a sec. So, yeah, we have this black glass with black wool under it here, which, especially in the textured pack, just looks really messed up and confusing. But that's the effect that I was going for.
Because of the reflection?
Yeah. And having, like, black blocks under black glass, it's just, you don't kind of quite know where the floor is. So that's what we've got going on there. Okay, well, as the sun sets...
So pretty.
Mm-hmm. So as the sun sets, shall we
go
have a look at the just the little mechanism we have set up for the enchanting table and stuff?
Welcome.
Thank you. Right. So here we're in the Eureka Map 2 Memorial Library. Which is so named because Map 2 was our favorite map. May it rest in peace. Rip in pieces.
Well, it was the first map we played on together.
Yes. I joined on Map 1, but Map 2 was the first map that we played on together. You are correct.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And we were neighbors.
Yes. It was all very adorable. Well, we were neighbors and now we've moved in together.
I know.
Things are moving along.
Things are moving along.
Yeah.
So I think I got. I think I got
her snagged, folks.
What do they say? If you like it, put a ring on it.
Yes. Well, there was that diamond ring I bought you in Terraria that one time.
Oh yeah, that was fantastic. It was like 2 platinum.
Yeah, it cost 2 platinum.
Oh. I actually said it like that at the time.
Yeah, she felt I spent an excessive amount of platinum on it.
Well, we were just starting off, and we didn't have, you know, that much platinum.
Well, you know,
eventually, you know,
you have to have priorities. I must strengthen the bond between us.
But 2 platinum.
Toe.
Toe. That's what it was. Toe.
I did was so bizarre because I was starting to take a drink of water as I did it, so it came out like Popeye or some shit.
Okay, anyway, so moving on.
Yes.
Do you want to watch? Should I do this?
Yeah, so we have this enchanting station.
I'm pretty sure this isn't very impressive because people on the server do like shit tons of much more impressive redstone stuff.
This is very basic redstone.
I think
but
people on the server that do the redstone stuff is Ark.
Arc Helix,
aka
Code, and whatever numbers came after Code. That was his old name.
That was his old name.
He will be forever Code to us.
He will.
Mm-hmm.
And Kindleus or Kindleus?
Mm-hmm.
Kindleus? Yeah, I think they...
I'd guess Kindleus.
Kindleus, yeah. They do all... We just
or it
call
could
them
be Kind Alas.
Kind
maybe it's like maybe it's two words shoved together.
Maybe. But from what I understand, they are like the redstone, you know, people on the server.
So what we're saying is we suck, but we tried.
Yeah, so we did. We did this really simple redstone. And yeah, I've done other redstone things before that were much more complicated.
I can confirm.
I mean, it was, what is it, flower farming?
Which,
for all the things to make, you know, to use redstone for, flower farming isn't really...
Flower farming's pretty legit.
Is it?
Yeah.
You know.
I had a shop and everything on
Map 2.
Sorry?
I had a shop and everything in Map 2. The mall, remember the mall?
Oh, yeah. I remember the mall fondly. You had your flower shop, I had my shop that sold packed ice and vines.
It was vinyl. Ice?
I called it vanilla ice.
Yeah, it was great.
Terrible pun.
Moving on.
Yeah.
Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Bam.
It's in sequence.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we set up the timings, so it did that. Do it again. Yeah. Do it again. Put it the other way. Yes, so we got sick of putting torches.
Well, I got sick. More like I got sick of you leaving the torches, because normally I would just, you know, put torches here, and that worked.
Carry on.
I would just take them off.
I'm gonna let you finish.
I'm gonna take them off, but someone who I shall not name would do a bit of like that and then leave it.
Actually it was, I was going to put the last one down and say it was more like that actually. So but, you're wrong.
Yeah. I was like, fuck that.
Mm-hmm.
So now we have that.
Yes.
Yes, well, you know.
Well, if you don't want me to leave torches on bookshelves, then stop leaving the toilet seat down, okay?
Wait, we don't even have a toilet.
Well, what have we been doing all this time? The Minecrafters shit in the woods? Oh, you go behind there. That's rather... This is a library! God damn it. Do you have no respect? Okay, so we got that. Basically what it is there's a bunch of redstone repeaters back here with different timings set so that we can have some commitment sequence. The end. It's very simple.
And they go around the enchanting table so it covers and it works. It totally works.
So if we want low level enchantments, we just flip the switch. Okay, so I think now it might be time to move on to the pièce de résistance.
We spent way too much time talking about.
Wait, I'm actually gonna go and check how long we've been recording so far. We've been on for like 35 minutes or something.
It's not too bad. We're nearly done.
Okay,
so this is the cobble hobble, which cobble hobble. You've shown people.
It has cobble. In chess. The end.
And now we have a double bed.
Yeah, this is like our we sleep in the cobble hovel. We never want to forget our humble roots. Now.
That is correct. That's where we start.
So okay, hold on. Let me step back a second to... So this house, which is almost entirely all the Countess's work.
Almost.
And you're going to tell me about it. What you're going to do?
Well, actually, I got this one. I did get the idea for it on YouTube, like just sort of looking at different designs. Uh-huh, but it's not like a copy. It's just more like an
amalgamation.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. I don't remember who it was that I saw that did this, but it's I think part of the problem I was having was that a very traditional house in this area just did not fit. Because I tried.
Yeah, we were thinking about like a old-fashioned southern mansion, weren't we?
Yeah, but it just didn't fit with the, with the environment, essentially.
Because
we have all the hills and, like, the trees and the snow, and it just wasn't working.
So we wanted
something more woodsy. And I think suggested an alpine...
A Swiss chalet or something, which is not exactly what we have here, but it's kind of like a Swiss chalet.
But I did try, and it just seemed like too much, like, I don't know, it was too flat or too, like, not enough, oomph, I guess, I don't know.
Not enough bleh. Oomph. Is that UMF or OOMPH?
No, not oomph. Oomph. I don't know. Whatever. You decide.
Decide for yourselves, viewers, which variety of oomph you prefer. Anyway,
I think you place the mailbox, which is probably the best part of the house.
I'm just kidding. Yeah, this is my contribution. It pretty much sets the whole thing off. This house would be nothing without it, is what we're saying.
No, you did do the stairs, although we had to make it. Mistakes were made. By me, actually. And originally we had this too wide, which didn't make any sense because everything is in odd numbers.
Yeah. Odd numbers are your friend.
Odd numbers are your friend when you're building. Yeah. So then we actually made it three wide and it turned out better.
I concur.
So essentially it's the sort of pattern of like, see, maybe we can come over on this side.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Tell me what viewpoint you want me to take, something like this.
Well, yeah. So if you look at the front of this one, if you can manage it.
Essentially
you have like this bottom, portion with cobble? No.
Just various brick. Types of stone. Brick. Although, yeah, although there's sure. some acacia logs mixed in there too, because they're the right sort
they
of color.
They look kind of stone-ish.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then you have a top portion, which has green clay and then like wood log lining or, you know.
Various different kinds of trimming.
And lots of trimming, lots of, you know, just random details. It's busy, but it works in that way.
Mm-hmm. Well, you certainly got busy in its construction.
Yeah, I was working on it for some time because, you know, I kept not liking things.
Like, well, this is how it works. This is how it works. You are just perfectionistic enough to make things look all... have you seen the shadow of
the pyramid?
Of the mob farmer or the soon-to-be pyramid coming down? This happens every morning. This oppressive shadow comes down over our house. It's kind of hilarious.
So I'm still working on the lighting and the roof and stuff.
Hence the torches.
We have a couple redstone lamps with daylight sensors right now that some of them,
there.
You know...
And there.
Yeah,
and
the corners.
There.
But other than that, we haven't really finished the lighting. So the outside, you know, is pretty straightforward. Oh, did you see the pond?
No, let's go around here.
Yeah. Or maybe this is a better... Oh, yeah, there's a little... Oh, we'll get to that.
Oh, we have a little framed here.
So we have a little pond.
Uh-huh.
And it's, you know, it's functional.
Yeah, yeah. And like with lots of just little bits of detail, like the plant pots at different levels, a couple of lily pads, bit of path, a couple of brick slabs, just lots of little things to make it look sort of interesting and kind of organic. There was one thing down here that was my idea. I actually did something for a change. This is brown stained clay? At the bottom?
It might be brown or black.
The idea is that the mud, it should be, when it's wet, it should be dark colored. So,
yeah.
Yeah. See?
That was a good idea.
I got the brains.
And we already had some running water down here, so I just, made it run both ways. That was pretty straightforward.
Are we ready to go indoors?
Yeah, but let's do it from the front.
Okay. That's right.
I feel like people on the server build some really impressive stuff, and like this is just sort of like small in comparison.
Size isn't all that matters, is what I try to convince people.
Okay. So this is the main entrance.
Mm-hmm.
And we have our friend, the Kurgan.
The Kurgan.
Yeah.
That's
we were supposed
name.
To have the Corgan as well.
Yeah.
But he despawned.
Were we going to call him Billy Corgan or just the Corgan?
No, just the Corgan and the Kurgan.
Yeah, yeah. His name is all in caps.
Pikmin.
And the Corgan was going to be like in normal grammar, I suppose. Yes, yes.
The main entrance, and we have carpet with
the jacksaw lanterns.
That's pretty straightforward.
Mm-hmm.
And this sort of little zen seating for the two of us.
Have you seen how tasty this shit looks? It's so nice.
Very with, zen.
With the green and the patterns in the ceiling, and this thing here. With the sort of lattice worky thing. I think that's really cool. And the different... These are all sort of different kinds of logs. I think this is different from this, which is different from this. But
it's just a lot of detail.
Yeah, yeah. It sort of gives some nice it sort of looks really simple, but at the same time, there's a lot of sort of variation and detail.
Mm-hmm.
Which is...
I would live here.
Me too. Well, we kind of do.
Oh. Noel, well, actually, Kite is in charge. We just live here.
Oh, that's very true. Although we do have to bring Kite to live here, which is not something that we have done yet. Oh, the Kurgan's coming down the stairs. I think he's been in the study reading up on the Austrian model of economics.
On the computer.
Oh, yeah, on the computer. Yes.
And these down here are slabs, so you don't really need a lot of lighting.
Which allowed you to put stairs here as the, I don't know, supports legs. Or legs on this bench.
On the little bench.
And we can look out of the window at this far. Oh, wait, I've got a torch in my hand, which makes things go blurry. Interesting, huh?
I just have an empty hand usually when I'm...
Sonanda.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. It looks nice. Your farm.
It is kind of nice to look out on, isn't it? And then you have these pot plants here. We do still have to get a baby pig man.
We do, although we haven't gotten another one.
No.
And this is just, you know, the back door.
It's a door.
It's in the back.
It's just in case you don't know, you know.
Yeah,
okay. Learn how to Minecraft, okay? It's a door. Yeah. Right, okay,
this
now
what? This isn't anything yet, but it's going to be for our potions and whatnot. Because it's just sort of like all cobblestone and stone and sort of rooms.
You need to be careful with potion making with chemicals, and you could get explosions, you could, you know, toxic spills, anything.
We don't. Toxic spills. So it's the future potion room of greatness. So now we're going to head upstairs. And I don't think we finished the lighting up here because we were trying to figure out how to get this little corner well lit, but you know, we'll get around to it, I think.
Yeah, well, yeah. It's basically, it's mostly done. We have a little bit of work to do there with the lighting, but carry on.
But this is the study / you know, bedroom, I guess. Like, it's an all-in-one.
Well, when
we have this, like, enormous house and just one little room to do everything else.
Indeed. So, so I guess if you're studying and you're tired, you can take a power nap right here, is the idea.
Yep. So this is our computer.
This is our computer. It goes click. It's very advanced.
Oh, there's extra beds and stuff in here. I didn't even know that.
These chests are supposed to be like filing cabinets or something, aren't they?
Yeah. Well, this one doesn't open since we put the computer on it. But yeah.
Oh, that's true. That's where we keep all our secret files that we don't want anyone to know about. Actually, so we don't want that to open too easily.
You need a key for it. You know how desks sometimes have like one side that has like a lock? That's what it is. Good idea.
So if you don't have any, you know, bobby pins, you can't get into them.
Exactly.
Fallout 4 reference. Go and watch my Fallout 4 videos.
God.
Sweet. Right.
So we have a little balcony.
Oh, the screen here for the computer. Here, it's... Yeah. It's
clearly he was reading some really, in-depth, complicated... gibberish.
Yeah, I'm looking at it. I can't even understand it now.
I know.
So there's a little balcony to look out on the mountains. Should we need to take a breather from our hard studying of quantum phenomena or such like, or funny pictures of cats.
Yes, because that's what the internet's for.
It's for quantum phenomena and cats.
Percentage.
It's all tied together by Erwin Schrödinger.
I wonder what percentage of the internet is just cats.
Isn't it 100%?
Maybe.
Yeah. There's cats in my videos, and that's basically it.
And that's it. That's it.
The it's only stuff that's worth video. Anything anyway, you know. So, we have a little kind of alcove-y thing here. There's sort of a narrow roof above our heads, which looks pretty nice from the outside.
This won't spawn anything. So
we have the same kind of bench here with the stairs.
And then you have more room of nothingness, just wide open space.
Yeah, just like a hallway. I can take a slight bit of credit for this part, although the design was basically... the Countess built it, and then I came around and fiddled with it. Yeah, I could almost say that I did half of this or something. I don't know.
Come over here and look at the window, and you get the god rays through the window.
Oh, right. Yeah, you get it coming through the the trapdoor. Oh, wow. It changes as you open and close the trapdoor. That's really cool.
Does it?
Yeah. Hold on. Go over there. Let me show you. Okay.
Huh.
Yeah, yeah.
Do it again.
Okay.
That's really neat. That's
fancy.
I wasn't expecting that.
I like it.
So, yeah. I mean, we have these sort of... I used fence gates here, so you can go out, although, you know... If we jumped off, I'm pretty sure we would severely injure ourselves since we're not wearing any armor.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
But that's how I was sort of basically getting to the roof to you know.
Yeah. As you mentioned up here, I don't know if I can even get to it. No, I can't.
Can you see the one on that end?
Oh, right. Yeah, yeah. This lantern has actually lit because it's dark enough because it's getting night. So there's a daylight sensor up on here that turns on the lantern.
Yeah, because apparently, and you know, this is because we were playing Feed the Beast in 1.7.
Mm-hmm.
The last time we played Minecraft. Daylight sensors, now you just like click on them. It used to be you had to invert them.
Oh.
But now they have a reverse setting. You just.
Oh, right. I didn't know that.
Pretty sure.
I rarely know anything about redstone.
I remember using daylight sensors before and having to invert them. But now it's just, you just click on it and you can change it.
Yeah.
I could be wrong.
Oh, and we just have a little cupboard of storage in here. Nothing special.
Nothing in it.
Nothing.
Nothing.
I like the way that the ceilings are very kind of far away and dark and shadowy. Part of that effect will be because of the shader pack that I'm using, so I don't know whether that will look the same to everyone, but that's how it looks to us. So that's what we're going by. The headboard and footboard, or whatever you'd call it, of the bed, that's pretty neat. We just have a wooden block here, because that's the best idea we could think of for that.
Ow! I totally missed the water there.
Oh, you're outside now. I see. Okay, so shall we start wrapping things up? Because hold on, let me just check.
Yeah.
We've been recording for like about 50 minutes or something. I don't know how much I'm going to edit this, if at all.
I feel like it lacked excitement.
Pizzazz. No, I think it was fine. We just talked a load of bollocks and... Oh, God, that hurt me so much. Because I'm not wearing any armor.
I know. Well, you know, I did say we needed some pizzazz.
Hold on. Let me try to see how much I can hurt you in one shot.
Oh, I nearly died.
That's quite hilarious. So, wait, no. So, I was using, I was using a power 4 bow right there.
I only have a power 3 bow. That seems unfair.
That's probably why then, you know, get on my level. So, that's what we got going on right now. We've pretty much.
Are you full health yet?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, I went down to 3 hearts.
I have a punch too. Do you have punch?
No, I don't have any punch, I don't think. Nah, I don't, just power.
Okay.
So I think we've pretty much covered everything, haven't we?
Yeah,
you know,
we've got
the spawner, the barn and farm.
We're going to do something about the lighting because we just have torches everywhere.
Yeah, that is going to be quite a gargantuan task, setting up concealed lighting using... I don't know, like leaf blocks and jack-o'-lanterns.
Jack-o'-lanterns, uh-huh. Yeah.
But, well, you know, we'll do that bit by bit. We have this rather stupendous looking house, or at least I think so. That
I want to build more, like something else, somewhere else. I just don't know what yet. I guess that's sort of my thing. I like building.
Yeah. So yeah. This house is more or less finished, really, pretty much. Mm-hmm. So
yeah, I just need to do the lighting.
Yeah. So we've got lots of space for building other things of various types. It's going to be fantastic.
If anyone has any ideas.
Oh, yeah. Although you are inviting everyone to tell us to just build an enormous penis in the middle of our valley.
No, I think people are nice and they're not going to tell me to build an enormous penis.
I said penis, honey.
Oh, what the fuck is a penis?
It's like a penis, but it starts with a B.
Okay.
I think it's a thing on the internet. Anyway. Okay. Yes.
Internet.
Mm-hmm. What even is it?
Yeah, so if you have any ideas of what we could add to our little, I don't know, whatchamacallit?
Our menagerie of builds. That's entirely the wrong word to use, because menagerie refers, of course, to animals.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. But
well,
such
animal.
As... only for you, baby.
Oh, jeez.
Oh, I couldn't help
it. Oh, gosh. I'm going to, like, hide.
Yeah. She's going to hang her head in shame. Uh-huh. Oh, she's shifting there. Anyway, hi.
Hi.
I didn't mean what am I talking about?
Yes, you did.
I meant
okay.
Everything.
Anyways.
Okay. So, I think that's about it. We're going to call that the end of the episode.
Mm-hmm.
Hope you enjoyed it. If you do click the like button. It helps out rather a lot. Share with anyone that you think may be interested, entertained, or just generally oiled up. Yeah, I'm not sure why I went there. No. I would have flown off the hill and... Yeah, goodbye, everyone, forever. Yes, leave your comments, suggestions, and eulogies in the comments section below. And subscribe if, and only if, you'd like to see more. Ta-ta for now, chaps.